Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Welcome to another fresh video on Room Database. In the previous video, we have covered database implementation, and before that, we had covered data access object, converter, and entity. Now it is time to use the setup that we have created for Room Database and get started with the implementation of repository. But this is not the end of it. Later, this repository will be used by view model and then later composable. We will be discussing it in upcoming videos. So let's focus back on repository. But there is a small correction that we have to make in this current sequencing. Repository doesn't interact with entity directly. It actually interacts with the data access object. So we need to just swap the position of entity and data access object here. So let's do this and we are basically good now. So let's start the discussion on repository for Room Database. We will first try to address why the name repository. When view model that exists before repository asks for the data, the repository has to respond back with data. It can fetch the data from the underlying room database, or it can fetch it from cloud, that is another way to say from an REST API, or from a local file, or even a shared preference. If you don't know how to save and fetch data from these various mechanisms, then I suggest you watch Android Data Persistence playlist that is already there on this channel. So let's focus on repository now. As I said, the source of the repository can be very diverse. We can basically split this sequence into two sections. The scope of the things that exist on right side is very specific to database management. However, the scope of the responsibility for things that exist on the left side is much broader. So we can say it is whole data management aspect. That is the reason why there is a need for repository. It allows us to achieve better separation of concern between database and non-database logic. It allows us to establish centralized data control, abstracting all the underlying data management logic. We can reuse the code across the application wherever we need data integration. Last but not the least, it just simplifies the data management overall. Future enhancements will be much easier with this design pattern. Whatever we are going to discuss from now on is not directly related to Room Database implementation. We have already done that. But to give the closure to the proper usage of Room Database, we have to nail these remaining concepts. So let's start with how does this basic structure of repository implementation looks like. The most important argument that we have to pass to this particular class is data access object, because repository would need it to fetch the data from the database. Do not worry about the context. I shall explain it during the demo. Then we have declared some instance variables in the class. Nothing fancy here. They are used to basically hold the data. Then comes the function called as fetch and insert all. Well, it fetches the data from the API and then inserts it into the local on-device database, which is Room Database. Just recall the application that we are trying to build. We are supposed to show the scrollable cards of information about countries. It is this function that is doing all the work. Let's move on to get all countries. That is another function. It returns the list of countries. Then we have a function delete country, which deletes a country from the list of countries. You can observe that it expects a parameter to be passed. That is the country that you want to delete. Then finally, we have update capital. No surprises. It updates the capital of the country with something else, whatever we want it to be. A common observation that we can make across all functions is they are all suspend functions. What could be the reason? Well, because we will be invoking all these in either another suspend function or in coroutine scope. And why is that? Because these database operations and API call operations should not be done on UI thread. That's why. That is why we have written with context dispatcher IO as well. This basically allows us to switch the context and execute this code in IO coroutine dispatcher. If you are not familiar with these things, then I suggest you go through coroutine playlist. I have provided the link in the description section below the video. All right then, this looks pretty straightforward, but as they say, devil lies in the details. That is about right time for the hands-on. Let's get into a demo. So this is the application codebase that you are already familiar with. In the previous videos, we have implemented the app database, converters, country DAO. So now it is time to implement the repository. So this is the class that I have created, that is country repository. It's a class, it takes the context, and then it also takes the argument of country DAO. And what we have done with the instance variable, we have just initialized the context and all countries, initially it is empty list. The first thing that we will have to implement is fetch and insert all. So we will get started with writing a suspend function, that is suspend function fetch and insert all. And this we will have to write with context dispatchers.io. And inside this, what I want to do is check whether all countries is already initialized. If it is there, then I want to just return it. Otherwise, I will have to do the work of fetching it from the API. So let me do that. So to invoke the get all countries, we will have to first implement the get all countries. So we will implement the get all countries first. So once again, suspend function get all countries that returns a list of country if all countries dot is not empty, then return all countries. I think we did a mistake here. We will have to write equals with context dispatchers.io once again, and we cannot write return all countries. We will have to write return at context all countries, else we will have to fetch it from the data access object. So all countries is equal to data access object, that is country DAO dot get all countries, which is what we have implemented, and then return with context all countries. So it basically checks if this all countries is empty. If it is not empty, it returns the same thing. Otherwise, it initializes it by fetching it from the database, and this we have implemented here in the DAO, and then it returns the all countries. And now we will use this get all countries here, that is get all countries. If all countries is not equal to null and all countries dot is not empty, or I could have just simply written this part because anyhow we are initializing it with empty list by default. If all countries is not empty, then I don't have to fetch it, it's already there. So return with context, else I will have to fetch it from the API. Now we will make it simple for ourselves. We have a function here called as get country list from JSON, which is basically trying to parse the JSON file that we have under the raw folder and return the JSON file. So this can pretty much function like a API call. It's just that it is returning it from the local raw file. So what I will do is remove this JSON get country list. This sounds much better. And then because I want to mimic a API call, I will have to add a delay of few seconds. But to be able to do that, I will have to make it a suspend function and then delay of say 2 seconds. So just before returning, it takes a delay of 2 seconds so that it mimics a API call. Now coming back here to the repository, to fetch an API call, to make an API call, I can basically invoke that particular method. That is val country list is equal to get country list, and I will have to pass the context for repository. Let me import this properly. Yeah, we are done. And what is it returning? It is returning a mutable list of country. But if I recall correctly, the country DAO insert all doesn't take a mutable list. It actually takes a list. So what I will have to do is convert this mutable list into a simple list. Let me call it as country mutable list just to differentiate. Val country list, and this is actually a list of country. Country mutable list dot to list. So now I have a list of countries, and then country data access object dot insert all and pass the country list. This will basically insert all the things into the database, then return with context. So let me stop here. We will continue remaining part of the development in the next video. So stay tuned.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.